Hello, welcome to today's video. Alright, as you may have just noticed, we have got a kerbal which has just come from a serious accident. We were attempting to build the new DSS when there was a docking failure and everything exploded. What you witnessed was the kerbal just regaining stability of the craft. However, they are completely stranded with no way of getting home. We need to mount a rescue. There they are. Okay. Now hopefully, we have a craft that can get to them. We're going to try sand, I believe, the DSS returner. Alright. Now I've used this craft previously. Seems to be a fairly tried and tested craft. At least in a previous version it was anyway. Where are we? That's the one. Okay. Okay, hopefully it all goes well. I'm going to remove these kerbal crew. We're going to get maximum space. Where's the pilot, actually? We'll send the pilot. Alright. Let's get into position. Now, the craft can actually be completely autonomous if needed. However, for the sake of fun, we're going to send it up with one kerbal, seeing as it's just the one kerbal we're returning. Alrighty, what can we do? Where is the base? It's just there. So we just wait for it to do a nice orbit round. Alright, that's close enough. Let's go in 3, 2, 1. We have liftoff. Okay. Hopefully this goes quite well. Not too sure what to expect. Yes, so about the issue we had before. We're trying to dock a section, but I didn't realise I had the docking ports around the wrong way. The big docking ports are actually quite tricky to tell which direction they're facing. Upon further research, I worked out what to do. Nevertheless, we had a bit of an issue with the time warping, and I had a segment fire straight into the rest of the craft. Absolutely catastrophic. Now, we're going to do this the inefficient way. Hopefully, we don't topple over. Definitely don't want to topple over. I don't know if I've got enough fuel to do it the full inefficient way. I've been using much bigger crafts lately. So we'll see how we go. Push this to about just under 100,000. We'll go just over, shall we? Because we need the DSS bit to catch up to us. Alright. And... alright, that's enough. Let's wait till we get to 70,000. I'm sure we can do some physical time warping at this point. Now we're going to lose a lot of delta V here. Well, a lot of momentum, I should say. The delta V is just the change in velocity. Alrighty. Cool, we've hit 70,000. We can time warp appropriately now. And it's catching up. Excellent. Back to full throttle. And we'll get this into a nice position here, over the horizon. Hopefully we've got enough fuel to maneuver around and mount this rescue. Okay, first things first, we must get ourselves a nice stable low curve in orbit, which we seem to be doing fairly well here. We didn't actually lose too much momentum before. Okay, that's pushing out a little bit there. Push this out to a nice safe distance. There we go. And we'll set this as a target now. Okay. That is still ahead, so I think we'll push it out a little bit more. We should get it. There we are. Can that go down much? How low can we get that? Not really too low. Alrighty. Let's see if we can have a little bit of a play with a maneuver node somewhere around here. That's 135 there. Maybe that can be an appropriate one. That seems to be moving down nicely already. Oh, that was... I had a feeling that was a good spot to do it. A lot of relative speed to wipe off, though, with this maneuver. I think we can do that. Alright. And... cool. That looks quite good now. Get into position. And we'll move to the node. This should work well. Apoapsis and periapsis is all within a safe height. Yes, it is. Alrighty. Where are we? Get to about 10 seconds. Cool. We will get into our maneuver node now. Okay. Let's see how we go. And burn. Burn, 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 burn. Burn. Alright. We have done that first maneuver. How close are we? We are with 1.9. Can we make it smaller? We can, very much so. We're going to set this to target and a retrograde position. Alright, we will now time warp to a better position. We're going to go quite a bit of distance out here. We're going to watch our target different speed drop off significantly as we get closer and get into a closer orbit. It's catching up nicely now. There we go. Hopefully we can save it quite well here. Alrighty. We need to move right around here. We're in the opposite position to what we need to be. 138 meters per second is a fair bit of delta V to wipe off. Let's have a look. We are now getting closer. We'll get as close as absolutely possible here. Alrighty. Excellent. Alright, that's lining up well. So far this rescue is working okay. Let's see how we go. We're now hitting our descending node, coincidentally enough. Alright, we're in a good position here, I believe. Fire up full throttle. Well, not nowhere near full throttle, actually. We'll overshoot that if we do that. This craft is quite small, so it maneuvers quite easily. And get this to zero. Alright, close enough to zero. Alrighty. Now, I believe we are certainly quite close. We are going to... what do we have here? We got plenty of fuel here. Let us separate to the next stage. Oh. Excellent. Nicely done. Where is our target? Move to target. This thing is an extremely maneuverable craft, so perfect for these kind of maneuvers. And we're going to set it into a docking mode. Let's boost over for the rescue. Do 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 do. Don't know why the Jurassic Park theme song is appropriate in this situation, but goddamn do I think it's apt. Now we're heading over. Careful the time warp, that's how this problem happened in the first place. Oh, set to rotation, we don't want that. Linear movement. Here we are. Dun, 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 dun. Now, are there any appropriate docking ports which are still in use? Slow right back down. Okay, I don't believe there are any docking ports which are still intact on the craft. Or is there? Nope, they were completely blown to shreds. Which means we're going to have to EVA. You can do it, buddy. You can do it. And there's still a massive segment floating in the background over there. Okay. There should be a nice spot nearby where we can grab hold and board into this. How close are we? There is the hatch. Probably should have extended the ladder, but that's alright, it's only close maneuver. Alright, we are now safely in the DSS returner. Let us get away from this other death trap. Push aside. Okay. Get in into retrograde position. And firing engines. Should be good enough. Back into prograde position, and we can say goodbye to those bastards. Alright, let us go into the darkness. Back into prograde position, we'll get some lights on. No lights, that's fine. Let's see how we go. We're going to come around the dark side here, and hopefully we're going to land quite safely. Get ready into this position here. Much energy left? Let's leave this up. Plenty of electricity. Let's get these radiators activated. And time warp is now finished. Alright, we are beginning to descend. Descending. Now we're beginning to enter the atmosphere. We're now in the upper atmosphere. Does that make it the exosphere? I think the exosphere is actually much higher up than this. Ionosphere, perhaps. Okay, getting down, so far so good. Let's do some more time warping. Not too bad of speed. Can we surface land it? Ideally I want to come around back during the day. Well, we set that to 42, we'll see how that goes. We're certainly descending quite slow, but quite stable. Energy charge is looking good. We've got plenty of batteries on this beast. So far, so good. Yes, certainly. Alright, we're now beginning to burn a little bit. Let's get ourselves back into a stability assist position, and if we can lift up now, we want the radiators to take the full brunt of this. Yes, the cooling mechanism is beginning to work and we're wiping off some of that speed. Come into a slightly more inclined position. So we really want the radiators to take the full brunt of this heat. Looking good, buddy. Thank you for rescuing me. Is what I'm sure it's saying in its own Kerbal language. Meanwhile, there it is up there. I might have to send some form of bot up there later on to deorbit that, because it had absolutely no control. Not that it is designed to come back anyway. Alright, looking at this, we're not going to make it into daylight. But that's fine, we're going to land safely anyway. Looks like we're coming in nicely. Nice and stable. Still some significant speed. It's a very shallow orbit that we took. Didn't want to come in too sharp. Minimal G-forces. Shields. Cooling still doing well. Electricity, barely using any. All stages are working fine. RCS is keeping us in position. We are about to drop below 2,000 meters per second. Getting a little bit sharp, maybe that incline now. Bring that down, perhaps, if we can. It's hard to keep good control here. There we go. I don't want to put the nose down too sharp, as it's quite aerodynamic, this craft, which is a good thing, but it means we will pierce through quite sharply and we're not going to wipe off much speed. I want to wipe off speed. Coming in nicely. Atmosphere is definitely getting thicker. We are descending. Certainly much faster. Speed is dropping. Plenty of heat. Radiators are working a little bit harder. I think they're pretty much through the worst of it now. Electric charge is increasing. They're starting to have to work harder. So while they creeping towards 19% capacity. Oh, this one's at 30%. That's fine. We're pretty much through the worst of it now. Alrighty. Almost there. Okay. We're now through the worst of it. We're about to get rid of a lot of this heat. Excellent. Nicely done. Alright. We now want to rotate round. Just like that. And get rid of those heat shields. Alright. Prograde position. Let's move down nice and sharp. Yes, this is definitely a tried and tested craft, as you can tell. And, there's the pieces of returner debris we left. And if we have a look over here, we're about to be completely overtaken by the DSS that we just came from. Getting down, 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 down. Really getting through the thicker part of the atmosphere now. Alrighty. Do I have lights installed? I don't have any lights on this. I don't know why, but looks like I'm going to have to add some lights later. Alrighty. We're certainly quite safe now. We are at 10,000. Okay. Should probably add some flaperons of some form here as well. That's slowing down nicely. Okay. Slowing down more so now. Here we go. Getting there. Cool. Beautiful. I believe we can turn the RCS off now. I don't think we really need much more control. We can let the wind and gravity do the rest of this journey. Now, you might notice we have no landing gear or wheels. Well, we don't require it here. Not at all. Once these inflate, we will land nice and upright. There we go. Perfect. Alrighty. Now, back to surface speed, because you might have realised, hey, we were going a little bit fast then, but it's because we were set to orbit, not surface then. Alrighty. We're actually spinning a little bit here, but that doesn't matter, we'll be fine. It's only because of the time warp. Or something blew up, I think that was our heat shields we just fired off before. Or radiators, to be specific. So radiating the heat off. And we're going to land nice and safe. Any moment now. There we go. At 7 meters per second. And here we go. Pew. Oh. That was a little bit more eventful than first thought. But we've landed. Well then. That was a very successful rescue. Didn't really take that long either. So. Well, hopefully you enjoyed that. Not as many explosions as I would have liked. But. Yeah. Until next time, guys.